Hey everyone, this is Josh Carney from Carney Media Group and the Music Tech Help Guy YouTube channel. Today I want to talk about recording guitar with two microphones. To demonstrate this, Sweetwater was kind enough to send over the SE Electronics guitar recording package for us to check out. We live in a world where you can now just plug your guitar in DI and record with amp simulators, but nothing really beats the tone of using a real amp with real microphones. So that's what I want to demonstrate in this video today. And the SE Electronics guitar recording package is a really easy way to do this, even on a home studio budget. So let's check out what's included with this package. So it wouldn't be a Sweetwater purchase without candy, so that's always a nice touch. And then there's two microphones. A Shure SM57 and an SE Electronics X1R. Ask any guitarist or engineer, and the SM57 will always be mentioned as a standard for recording guitar amps. The X1R is a nice touch because it's a ribbon mic. So again, ask any engineer about layering the SM57 with a second mic, and most will say that the best option is to layer the 57 with a ribbon mic. The recording package also includes two 20-foot microphone cables. And lastly, there's a custom SE Electronics reflection filter, which is tailored for guitar recording. This is great because it helps isolate the microphones from the rest of the room, especially in less than optimal recording situations, like in a home studio, office, or bedroom. So the reflection filter serves as the stand for both mics, and it positions them right next to each other. Typically, when you use two close mics right next to each other, you want the capsules for the mics to be the same distance from the source to maintain phase coherency. If you place one mic a bit further away, the mics can be out of phase, and the two mics can start to work against each other rather than complementing each other. This is because the distance from the source affects the time in which the sound reaches each mic. And depending on the distance of each mic, this can also cause the audio to be out of phase, causing some nasty phase cancellation and comb filtering effects. Now with that said, it's actually pretty common to make small distance adjustments with a pair of mics on a guitar amp to affect the tone in a constructive way. The great thing about this reflection filter is that you can push or pull the SM57 to adjust its relative distance to the X1R to affect the tone. And you can also adjust the position of the X1R as well. So I've got a Mesa Boogie Mark III amp along with a Mesa Boogie 4x12 cab, and I'm gonna set up the mics on one of the bottom speakers, slightly off-axis. Off-axis means that I'm not placing the mic directly in front of the center of the speaker cone. The closer to the center of the speaker cone, the more high-end you'll get. As you move away from the center of the cone, you'll get a warmer tone with less highs. After recording, you can blend the two mics in the mix to customize your tone, or you can pan them left and right for a bit of stereo width. What I like to do is double track the rhythm guitar parts for a total of 4 tracks, and then play with the panning of each track to create a big, wide guitar sound. So So that's the SE Electronics guitar recording package available at Sweetwater.com. It's a great way to record your amp, even on a home studio budget. I've been a Sweetwater customer myself for over a decade now. They have a great selection of products, great sales and technical staff, and free shipping as well. I'll leave a link to the SE guitar recording package in the video description below. I hope you enjoyed this video, and thanks for watching.